In Mastercam 2025, we introduced the Mastercam Deburr toolpath. We created a What's New video that goes through the basics of it, and in this video, we're going to go into it in greater detail to learn how we can save on programming time and decrease our cycle times. I'm going to pick up where the last video left off with this part, already programmed on one side. I'm going to quickly flip the part over and program the back. So I'm just going to set to my bottom plane, go right into the Deburr toolpath. And just like before, I'm going to choose the same tool. Under cut pattern, I'm going to choose the entire part with a triple click. And for my excluded edges, I'm just going to go through and do a control shift double click to select these holes and this one here as edges to ignore, right? We're not going to machine those with this Deburr toolpath. Other than that, the constant width is going to be the same at 0.5 millimeter. Let's click OK. All right, and let's take a look at this toolpath motion. Specifically, in one area here, we notice that the toolpath is coming down the wall. We may not want that, right? In this particular case, I don't want this. And if we do a quick backplot of just this area, you'll see that the toolpath, in fact, is going down this wall here that we want to ignore. So how do we ignore this, or how do we avoid this? Well, there's two options in the toolpath, actually multiple. The first one, under the cut pattern advanced edge options, is we can limit the area by height. So we could kind of dial in the height of where we want this toolpath motion to go. The other thing we could do, which is what we're going to do here, is I'm just going to add that to the excluded edge. So I'm going to right click, add. I have my surface selection, my edge selection turned on. I'm going to click OK. That's the edge we're going to avoid. When I regenerate, so we see here that the toolpath obviously ignores that edge. And not only that, you'll notice that as it comes around this corner, we have nice smooth motion where it's not even leading off and leading back on into the model. It just goes right around the corner and ignores that vertical edge. Okay, so you might be wondering here, what's the difference between something like this and our model chamfer toolpath? Well, specifically, the model chamfer toolpath uses chamfer mills. It also requires 2D planar chains. So in a case or a situation like this, it would work great. And in fact, the model chamfer toolpath would not go down that edge, right? And actually, it couldn't, right, with the shape of the cutter. However, if we flip the part around, you'll notice that we have some complex shapes here, particularly this shape right here. And if we kind of look at the existing Deburr toolpath, we'll see what I'm talking about. This shape right here, this is a three-axis simultaneous tool motion, right? This is not a planar chain. So the model chamfer toolpath would not work here, all right? If we wanted to chamfer this with a toolpath, we'd have to go with a contour toolpath and probably set our cut settings to a 3D chamfer. Okay, so what we did was we took the multi-axis Deburr toolpath and made it more applicable to a three-axis environment. So this means generating G1 moves, which is more conducive for a three-axis environment. So it's a three-axis simultaneous toolpath. And this includes 3+2 functionality. So let's explore that now. So with this model, if we take a look at this feature on one side, we'll notice that there's a hole here that's been drilled at a unique angle, right? I don't even know what the angle is. So how does this get handled with Deburr? Well, the original Deburr toolpath that we created will machine this. And you'll notice here with some of the motion that we have, you'll see that this motion right here will get some of that edge. But it won't get all of it because of the orientation of this feature. So let's go in and create a plane that we can use for our tool plane, and then we'll actually create a Deburr toolpath just to machine out this feature. So I'm gonna go into my model prep. I'm gonna do whole axis. I'm just gonna select this circular cylindrical face here, and this will be my geometry that I'm gonna use to define my plane. And then I'm going to go into the planes manager, and we'll do from geometry, and we'll just grab this arc. It's pretty easy to define the plane that way. And I'll make sure that my WCS is still set the same, but my tool plane is going to be set to this new plane. Okay, so now with that set, we'll go right into the deburr toolpath. Now for this, I'm gonna choose a smaller 5mm ball end mill. And that's really because this hole is kind of small, so it'll have more room to clean out that edge with the smaller tool. For the cut pattern, same thing as before. We're gonna select the entire part as machining geometry. But for the edge definition, I'm gonna choose user defined, and I'm gonna specifically tell it which edges I wanna machine. In this case, it's going to be this edge here and this edge right here. So those two edges. Everything else should be the same. I just wanna point out I'm gonna keep the same edge shape. Tool axis control is still set to 3-axis, and we're gonna click OK. And as we see here, we have a nice toolpath motion. Let's take a look and verify and see what we actually get, right? So I'm gonna select this most recent toolpath, our original one, and the stock model, and go right into verify. Okay, so let's skip ahead to this next toolpath. And at this point, I'm gonna hit play so we can see the motion coming through. And we have color loop turned on, so again, it's gonna show it in a different color. But as you can see, we have our cleaned up edge or deburred edge with this toolpath. And looking at it from the side, we can see that we have nice clearance there. All right, so as you can see, this is a very powerful toolpath. If your machine is capable of this kind of toolpath motion, but maybe you don't have a multi-axis license, the Mastercam Deburr toolpath can support a lot of your multi-axis deburring needs. Saving on labor-intensive manual post-processing of your parts. You can just have your machine take care of it with Mastercam Deburr.